So the great thing about Scratch is that you can have one sprite and one backdrop, but you can actually add more and create whole worlds and whole stories based on all those different options that you have. Let's start with adding another sprite. So here you'll notice I've kind of got a creepy Halloweenish theme going on with this old, really, really desolate forest and a bat as my main sprite. But you could add another sprite if you wanted, and there are four options for adding an additional sprite, similar to what we talked about a couple of modules ago. Do you remember where those options are? That's right. You'll see where it says New Sprite here. There's a couple of different options that you can choose from. You can either choose a new sprite, draw another one, select one from your file, or you can go ahead and take a picture and make that your sprite if you would like to be a sprite yourself. Now, if you want access to each of them, you just have to go back and forth. So let's go ahead and try that. We're gonna go ahead and pick a new sprite. Since I have sort of a forest theme going on, let's go with another bat. Perfect. Bat one is going to function as our second sprite. And we'll go to okay. Boom. Now you'll notice that you have bat two and bat one, which I can go ahead and move over here so that they don't look like they're on top of each other. Now, if you want to switch between them, all you need to do is go ahead and click on them back and forth. The great thing about having two sprites is that you can have them do different actions at the exact same time. So let's go ahead and practice this, and we're going to use looping since that's something that most of you have come to understand. So we'll go to bat two, and we'll start off with just some basic points. So we'll go to events, and we'll do when green flag is clicked. Okay. Now, in order to do looping, do you remember how you go ahead and do that? That's right. It has to do with your control button. So let's do looping with repeat 10 times. We'll click that in. And then for a motion, let's go ahead and make him move 10 steps. Now, if we want him to move 10 steps and we want it to repeat 10 times, it's just going to look like he goes 100 steps, 10 times 10. So let's make sure that he can pause so we can see him moving each of those 10 steps one at a time. So we'll go back to control. And we'll go to wait 1 second. So now every time he moves 10 steps, he'll wait 1 second, move 10 steps, wait 1 second, move 10 steps, and keep going and going and going. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. There you go. Moving 10 steps, waiting 1 second, and the looping is helping it repeat. So as soon as he finishes, I'll show you how to do bat number one's action. Perfect. Now notice what happens when we go down and we click bat number one. All of a sudden over here, everything in our scripts area has disappeared. But it actually hasn't. If we go back to bat number two, there are the commands that we have for bat two. But bat number one is a whole different ball game. So let's go ahead and pick something different for bat number one to do so that you see the two different actions happening at the exact same time. So we'll go back up to events and we'll again do when green flag is clicked. Go back to control. Which of these blocks do you select? That's right. Let's go with repeat 10 times, but instead we'll do repeat 5 times. Now let's go back to motion. We'll select a different type of motion this time though, so that you see the two different things happening at the same time. We'll do turn 15 degrees. Snap that in. And so we can see the wait time again, we'll go ahead and pick wait. But this time we'll do 2 seconds. All right, let's go ahead and see what happens with this. Now, we're only going to go ahead and click this part here, because if we were to click the green flag, what do you think would happen? That's right, both sprites would do their actions at the same time. So let's just see what bat number one here is actually going to do himself. He's slowly turning, waiting 2 seconds every time it happens. Excellent, very nice. Okay, so to sum it up, let's see if both of these sprites do their actions at the exact same time. I'm going to move bat number 2 over here and bat number 1 right here so that you can clearly see what's happening between both of them is the exact same time. Here we go. Perfect. That is exactly what we wanted to happen. Both of the sprites are following their specific commands, but at the same time. Each of them has commands in their own scripts area, and so they're not necessarily doing the same thing, but their actions are overlapping. Voila! Different actions for different sprites. Now we're cooking. You know, come to think of it, maybe I should make a picture of myself racing with some Olympic athletes, and then maybe I'll just make sure that I move faster than them. Oh well. Either way, see what else you can come up with. Tinker around and see what sorts of actions can you make happen with multiple sprites at the exact same time.